one more time.
Amen. Give an honor to God.
Yes.
To Pastor Bridges.
Amen.
Thank you, the Lord, for her to give me this chance to proclaim the word.
Amen.
One more time.
Amen.
And
to Bishop.
Bless you, brother.
Rodney Wilkins.
Bless you.
Amen. It's good to be
bless you.
In the presence of him one more time, too.
Amen.
For those of you that have your Bibles, there we go. What was it going to pull up? 1 Thessalonians 5:18. 1 Thessalonians 5:18.
Amen.
I'm going to try not to be before you very long. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. In everything, yes, 1 Thessalonians 5:18. In everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. For a few moments, I'm going to talk about in everything, give thanks. Give thanks.
Amen.
We must give thanks in all circumstances. Not just once a year, but all the time. Always, continuously, to give the Lord thanks.
Amen.
For the last few months, this scripture has really been dealing with my personal life. So I found myself, Pastor Bridges, Bishop, that when I'm out just driving, I just start giving the Lord thanks.
That's right.
I look at the trees, I say, Lord, thank you.
Yes,
I can see the trees. Lord, thank you even for the vehicle I'm driving. Lord, thank you. Sometimes I look down at the gas tank. Well, God is half full of my gas light on, but still, thank you. In everything, give him thanks. Look over to my closet, see the few pair of shoes I got. I'm like, Lord, I thank you. I might not have a closet full of shoes, but the few I got, Deacon, Lord, thank you. Look at my wardrobe. I might not have 20 or 50 pair of pants, but Bishop, the few pair of pants I got, Pastor Bridges, I look at like, Lord, thank you. Amen. I done got word now since I know how to have some sleepless nights. And when I wake up in the morning and I had a beautiful night of rest, I'm like, Lord, thank you. For I rested well last night. My body wasn't racking with pain. And Lord, I got to give you some glory. I got to give you a thank you. Amen. A lot of times we ask the Lord to do this and do that for us, but we won't thank him as much as we should.
Yep.
Now, we go to the grocery store and somebody do something for us in kind, we'll say, thank you.
Yeah.
And somebody, step out of the way or pick up something for us, we'll say, thank you. Yeah. If we ask somebody for help and they help us do something, we'll say, thank you. But last time I checked, God do everything for us, but we slack and say, thank you, God. Amen. I remember about 8 years ago, Mr. Bridges, when I first started coming, you said to us, well, tell him thank you. Tell him thank you. Amen. So we in everything, we got to give the Lord thanks. Amen. You might not feel good in your body, but Lord, thank you. Somebody somewhere is worse off than I am. Lord, thank you. I might not have all my teeth of God, the ones I bought, but thank you.
Thank you.
Amen. You got to end everything. Give God thanks.
Yes.
God, I might not have 20/20 vision, but God, thank you. That my glasses helping me to see.
Yes.
Amen. You might be on high blood pressure medicine, different types of medicine, but God, thank you that this medicine is regulating my high blood. In everything, give God thanks. You might have a doctor visit, but God, on my way to the doctor's office, I thank you because who report I'm going to believe? I'm going to believe the report of the Lord.
Amen.
And so I'm going to tell God, thank you.
Amen.
You might go home to a mean spouse. God, I'm on my way home. I don't know. what Brother Cantaloupe going to say or Sister Squash going to do. But God, I thank you that I got a home and a family to go to. God, I thank you. In everything, give thanks.
Yes, yes.
God, I thank you for the roof over my head because somebody somewhere is sleeping on the streets.
Yes, yes.
God, I thank you for the food that's on my table. Because somebody got to go to the soup kitchen. But God, I thank you that I got some bread on my table. Got a little milk in the refrigerator. God, I thank you. Got some little beans up in the cabinet. God, I thank you. Got some stored up, cut up okra in the freezer. God, I thank you. Amen. Somebody, if you just got baked beans and some rice, you ought to say, God, I thank you. Because somebody don't even have baked beans and rice. Or you ought to say, God, I thank you for my baked beans and my rice.
Yes.
And Lord, to give God thanks, you open up more doors for God to supply you even more because you show God gratitude. You're giving God thanks. And so when we open them doors up like that, God will open up the windows of heaven and pour out more blessings upon us. Amen. So in your walk of life, I don't care where you at, you make sure you give God a thank you. Amen. You go to your job, God, I thank you. I don't even like coming here, but God, I thank you. But I got a job to go to, and I got a little check coming in. God, I can give a little bit back to you to help up build up your kingdom. God, I thank you. Amen. Thank you, God. We got to make sure we tell God, thank you. Because he didn't have to do it.
That's right. That's right.
He didn't have to wake us up this morning. He don't have to supply our needs. But God does.
God does.
And yes. Sometimes people are like, what my blessings are. You blessed every day.
Yes.
Every day you blessed. Yes. Because you ain't got what your next door neighbor have, don't mean you ain't blessed.
That's right. That's right.
When you are able to get up and put your own clothes on, you blessed.
That's right.
If you ain't even somebody, I see you, you are blessed. Amen. If you're in the homeless shelter, you are blessed. Yes, Lord. We are blessed just to be in Gaston. Why do you say that, evangelist? Well, thank you for asking. Because the hurricane and stuff like that comes around. Guess who was skipped Gaston in South Carolina? So God, I thank you for where I live at. I'm not on the coast where a hurricane comes, then I got to evaluate. God, I'm not in a hurricane main hit area. I'm a tornado main hit area. So God, I thank you for where I live.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Thank you.
We got to evaluate our lives.
Yes, yes.
And make sure we are thankful to God.
That's right.
Amen. Thank God for being able to bathe yourself.
That's right. Yep.
Because some people can't even bathe themselves.
That's right. That's right.
I had my aunt and my cousin to help bathe my mother as she was going down with dementia.
Uh-huh.
So don't get beside yourself because one day you might need somebody help.
That's right. That's right.
So yeah. While you able to do for yourself,
uh-huh.
You better say, God, I thank you.
That's right. That's right.
If you're able to go in the kitchen and cook for yourself, you ought to say, God, I thank you.
Yeah.
Because somebody is not able to cook for themselves, so they got to wait on meals on wheels. God, I thank you. I can go in my kitchen and cut on my oven. God, I thank you. I can open up a refrigerator and pull out something. Because somebody, I didn't even used to have strength enough to open the refrigerator up. But somebody don't even have enough strength to get up and move about. If you got enough strength to get up and move about, you want to tell God, thank you. Then it goes on to say, we as Christians are to give God, give thanks to God in every circumstance of life.
Yes, yes, yes.
So if you're a freaking flyer, you all say, God, I thank you that the airplane land. If you love travel like this, go up and down the road to Baltimore, I think that's right.
Yep.
And when you make it back or when you go to and fro, like, Lord, I thank you I made it to the destination.
Yes.
Amen. We got to tell God, thank you. If you used to be going to and fro to the doctor's office like I was, Lord, I thank you that I don't have to go to the doctor as much as I used to. So, God, I thank you. So, God, I thank you that I used to be on 5 medications, but now I'm down to 1. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. So if you know, you all say, God, I thank you. Then when I get myself an instrument shot, it works every time. You all say, God, I thank you. Amen. Because sometimes people take medicine, it don't work. So if your medicine works and you taking it, you all say, God, I thank you. That my medicine work. Amen. I don't care. I would say, God, I thank you. But when I used to take my green pills all the time, even though I had to take a nap, but God, I thank you that my migraine pills, man, you know, did his job. So God, I thank you. Amen. Amen. Then the one say, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you.
Yes.
It's the will of God that we rejoice always.
That's right.
And give him praise. Church Caesar wrote a song about old shouting John. And at the end of the song, he said, I feel like praising him. We got to feel like praising God every now and then. Yes, you all get the feeling you all want to praise God with a thank you.
Yes.
David felt like praising God so much that the Bible said that David praised God out of his clothes.
Yes.
Amen. So you ought to feel, you ought to know that God done did so much for you. That around your house, you ought to give God a thank you praise. Go to the grocery store. You have to buy a little bit more than you did last week. You ought to give God a thank you praise. You might be in a Walmart around the cornflakes. Or you might be over there around the produce aisle. Somebody might see you just doing a little thing. You just like to praise God. I just said, God, I thank you. And last week I went there to my father's, but God, I thank you. And this week I'm able to buy a little bit more than I did last week. God, I thank you. When you get up and the aches and pains in your body is not that bad as it was last week or a couple of days ago. God, I thank you that I got a few aches and pains in my body. Yes, sir. Ms. Bridges, you all say, God, I thank you. I'm not having to run up and down the road to the doctor's office as much as I used to, but I got to know, but not as much as I used to. God, I thank you. Yes, sir. God, I thank you that I got a peace of mind. Amen. I got a peace of mind. The Bible says, you know, if our mind stayed on him who trusted in me, he'll give us a peace of mind. God, I thank you that I got a peace of mind. Somebody's mind is all messed up, Allison. Their mind is all messed up. They don't know if they're coming or going. But God, I thank you. I know if I'm coming, I know if I'm going. I say hallelujah to your name. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Somebody is down in depression right now. Don't feel like getting up. Don't feel like moving. Don't love themselves. Probably don't love nobody. But God, I thank you. I'm not in the mode of depression. I'm in the mode of thanksgiving. I'm in the mode of lifting up holy hands. I'm in the mode of running telling somebody about the goodness of Jesus. And done for me. Yes, sir. I don't know about y'all, but God's been good to me. He brought me from high, long way. I don't feel no waste high. I don't feel no waste high. I don't feel no waste high. Yeah, make it hard sometimes. I feel no waste high. I don't want to do this and next time, but I don't feel no waste high. Yeah, I don't feel no waste high. Because I know who's on my side. I know who has my back. Yeah. I don't feel no waste of it. And I believe he brought me this far just to leave me. He's not gonna leave you. They say, I've never seen the righteous forsaken. No, his thieves begging for bread. So God, thank you. I don't have to worry about you forsaking me. I don't have to worry about begging for bread. God, I thank you. The Lord is my shepherd. I say all I want. God, I thank you. You know my every need. God, I thank you. Yes. I thank you, Master. Thank you. Thank you. Another way, another
always need to talk to God. We always need to tell him what's on our mind and what's on our heart. If we talk to God like we talk to everybody else, amen, he'll show up a whole lot faster. If we talk to God like we get on Facebook and tell all our business, God will show up on your behalf. If we talk to God like when you get on the telephone and tell everybody else, if you tell him about it, I guarantee you, he will call back to you and let you know which way to go, and then everything's going to be all right. But we find ourselves talking to everybody except the man that made us. We find ourselves talking to everybody except the man that got our back. We find ourselves talking to everybody except the man that won't tell nobody what you told him. Then you get mad with somebody and tell your personal business when you should be talking to God about it all from the beginning. So God, I thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Psalms 9:11 says, I will give thanks to you, Lord.
Yes.
With all my heart.
Yes.
I will tell of all your wonderful deeds.
Yes.
You got to tell.
Got to tell.
About the wonderful deeds that he done for you. Sometimes we got to be like the woman at the well. We got to run and tell somebody about the goodness of Jesus.
That's right.
Psalms 104, enter his gates with thanksgiving.
That's right.
And his court with praise.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about. You got to praise.
Yes.
Praise him when you don't feel good. Praise him when you do feel good.
Praise
him when you're broke. Praise him when you got the money in your pocket. Praise him when you feel like cussing out the world. Praise him when you feel like giving the world a high five. You got to give God the praise. You got to give the praise, y'all. Philippians 4 and 6 says, do not be anxious for it, about anything, but in every situation. Every situation.
Yeah,
come on, Bishop. Get out. In every situation. By prayer and petition. With thanksgiving. With thanksgiving. Amen.
Yes.
Present your request to God.
Yes.
You got to present it, y'all.
Yes.
You got to give it to him. So whatever it is, give him thanks.
Uh-huh.
In every situation, give him praise.
Yes.
Amen. If Bishop, you get mad at the first lady later on, still give God praise.
That's right.
Bishop, I mean, Miss Bishop. If you give him that, and later on, just still give God praise. Amen. Hey, if I fall out later on today, I still got to give God praise. Because God's going to be the one that bring that thing back around to 1 o'clock. So we got to still give God praise. We see, we're going to give God praise in good times. We won't give God praise when we're happy. We won't give God praise when we go to the bank and put out $100. We won't give God praise when it's not to give us a bill report. But we got to give God praise in spite of. You got to give God the glory in spite of. And if your life business do, you don't know where the money coming from, you still got to give God the praise. Yes, sir. But you stop to get your bad report and you don't understand. You went for one thing and he told you another thing. You still got to give God praise. Amen. And this was your granddaughter. Going to and go to the doctor's office. You still got to give God praise. Let's this Mr. Richard. When you go up and down the road, you're going to be a bishop. When you go up and down the road, you still got to give God praise. Yeah, I know you want to go to work, Bishop. I don't have to go to work. I go to work anyway. I still give God praise. Somebody on my left got a nasty attitude. Somebody on my right don't know if they're coming or going. I said that God, I give you the glory anyway. God, I need your help. I got one who can take on my left, one crazy thought on my right. God, I still need to give you the praise. I still got to give you the glory. Thank you, God. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. Left might be talking about me. On the right might not think too much about me. But God, I still give you the praise. Still give you the praise. Yes, sir. We can't get mad and fight back. Let's give God the praise. If they get on your nerves bad enough, yeah, dance around. Yes, sir. Still give God the praise. give God the praise. We got to praise Him.
Yes.
We got to praise Him. Yes. If your car breaks down outside the road, give out, give God the praise. Yes, well, God, I thank you. Got a new car coming. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's what you got to do. You get mad and stand the door kicking. But now give God the praise. I see a new car coming. Children, they act right. Still give God the praise. Still give God the praise. God, I praise you because they coming in. They coming in, God. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. They coming in. Your spouse ain't doing right. Still give God the praise. God, they going to do right. I thank you. I thank you.
You
got to give him the praise, God. And you'll see how your atmosphere will shift. Because you got to praise. And God is pleased with the praise. Amen. Miss Bishop is jumping.
Go ahead. It's going to be all right.
Miss Bridget. When it seems like just you and two others may be here, but you still give God a praise.
Yes.
Amen. You still start coming together.
Yep.
But we can't let frustration kill our praise.
That's right.
We can't let a bad attitude come and kill our praise. Because
right.
In everything, we got to give Him thanks.
Yes.
We got to give Him thanks.
Yes,
yes sir. Got to give Him thanks. Because
yes.
I've been debating like, Lord, should I keep on working? I don't have to. I go where I don't want to go, but do I have to keep on working? Because, see, sometimes when the power is yours like that, I don't have to work, just go in there quick, but I don't want to abuse that.
Right.
I just want to, and because the Bible said, and now thy way, and now it's the Lord.
That's right.
And so I want to direct my path. What should I do? Amen. But in the midst, still in the midst, I still want to give Him praise.
Amen.
Because being in the work field, you learn.
You got to give Him praise.
You got that right.
You
learn a lot. It was all kind of different attitudes.
Yes, yes.
I thought working at the prison was bad. My Lord. But, my Lord.
Jesus.
But, yes, they are. Yeah, they just ain't locked up.
That's right.
But I give God the praise because by working, amen, that done brought me closer to God.
Amen.
Made me pray for my enemies.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
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 When you want to lash out, when that cussing spirit will get in, and I'm like,
yeah.
And God said,
uh-huh.
I got it.
Yes.
I got it. I got it.
Jesus.
When I want to tell them off, I'm going to wring your neck. God, I got it. Just hush. I got it. Well, majority of the time, they come back and apologize. And I...
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes! And I give God a little step, a little praise, because if we just let Him find out about it, amen, that's hard. I ain't going to say that's easy. Not for me. But when God speaks to me to step back and hush, I let Him fight my battle.
Yes,
amen, because... I be wanting to say some stuff sometimes. But when God, but see when God does it, He does it with perfect peace.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
You know, we was talking to the disciples, peace I give unto you. And that peace, that's why I want that peace of God that surpasses of all understanding. Amen. We might not understand it. Amen. But that peace is there, y'all.
It's there.
That peace is there. Amen. And it's up to us while we're giving God thanks and the praise. Do we want that peace?
Yes.
Do we want that peace? Because we, even though we human, things get inside of us sometimes, but we can break peace.
Yes.
But not let God be God. In other words, let God do what He do best.
Yes.
Let Him fix it. Let Him work it out.
Yes.
Because we can make a bad mess out of stuff.
Yes.
When God can just put the fire out, we'll make it bigger.
Yeah.
Amen. Because you know we can get some attitudes.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know we can get some folks told.
Yes.
We can make us feel that way.
Amen. I ain't that holy, y'all. But I might get somebody told. Y'all might be that holy. But I ain't that holy. I ain't made that yet, part yet. I might get there just wait on.
Hey.
Yeah. I might get there, but just hold on.
Yeah.
Amen. I might be a little slow, but I'm getting there.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Ms. Bridget, I might not say bless you to everybody. You might can, but I can't say bless you to everybody sometimes. Amen. Amen. I might want to.
Yeah. Yeah, but God is keeping. Amen. Yes, amen. Amen. Even though sometimes the old flesh rises up, you know, when you ain't prayed up, anything might happen. So when that old flesh arrives, then when God can put you back in check, that's a blessing. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Today is, that's what I love so much about God. If we just let God be Him, and we just step back, I said, let God do it. Let God do it. Because Humphreys know, Morgan Allison in Angelic Gospel sang a wrote a song. I got victory over the enemy, and the world can't do me no harm. As long as we keep singing that song in our head, we got the victory over the enemy, and the world can't do us no harm. We got to give God the praise. Yes. We got to give God the glory. Even though we wake up and seem like all hell done broke loose overnight, we still got to give God the glory, because it's up to us how long we going to weep in the midnight hours. Yep. And like I say all the time, that famous word, weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. That word may heals that point of, is you going to stay there or you going to come out of it. Amen. Because weeping may. Don't mean it have to happen or you have to stay there that long.
That's right.
But yeah, may. But if we get up on the wrong side of the bed and we stay on the wrong side of the bed, how we say it, and don't give it to God, that night time gonna stay a little bit longer, Miss Bridges. But if we give it to God, amen, that joy comes a whole lot quicker.
Amen.
Give God the praise. I don't care where you at, Terry. If you're walking up down the streets and some of them buddies trying to put, my friend, I got to give God the praise. What you doing ain't giving God the praise.
That's right.
Amen. Got to give God the praise. Young people at school, still give God the praise. Yeah. Amen. Give God the praise. You're going and you're coming. Give God the praise, because we're blessed in the field, in the city, our going in, our coming out. We are blessed. Amen. God bless. Amen. Thank you for that word. Give God thanks. Regardless of whatever you're going through, he said, you give God the thanks. God deserves the praise. He deserves the honor to get the thanks and the praises from us. Amen.
Amen.
That was a very uplifting message. That message should uplift anybody. And it should be an encouragement to anybody. I don't know if you got it, but I got it.
I got it.
It was for me. Oh, who got it?
I got it.
You get the message?
Yes.
To give God thanks and everything?
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Reverend Surrett,
yes,
for that word of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
This morning.
Yes.
For the food for his sheep.
Yes.
God always knows what we need.
Amen.
And I always love it when he sends you to feed me. Because I always enjoy it. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. He never has a message that will take you down.
That's right.
He always, Reverend Surrett, always has a message that would uplift those who may have a broken heart.
Amen.
It always uplifts some of those that may be going through some stuff.
Yes.
Some of those that may have fallen off the wagon. His message is always a positive message about God. That God can pull you up out of everything, but you need to give something back, even a little thank you.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
God bless you, Reverend Surrett. We thank you so much. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.